These are the Firefly Nano Baby V2 drones by Flywoo. They're 1S microquads that have two frame styles to choose from. The True X is designed for speed and agility, which is great for freestyle practice. And the Deadcat frame is tailored more for general cruising around and going through small gaps. I'll tell you the problems I ran into, as well as which option is best for you if you're looking for a 1S quad that's powerful and fun to fly. Let's start off with the flight experience and my first impressions. Flywoo sent us the analog ELRS FR16 and the HD0 ELRS DC16. So of course my experience will be based on these two particular models. Flywoo offers three options for the video system: analog, walk snail, and HD0. And the receiver options are FR Sky, Crossfire, Express LRS, or just without a receiver. Starting with the DC16, my first flight was indoors, and it took me a couple of seconds to get a feel for how much throttle it needed to stay in the air. I've noticed some microquads require a lot of juice just to maintain altitude, but this Firefly DC16 feels very powerful, and it's not too sensitive either, at least with the 450 mAh 1S battery. The flight times I got inside while flying at a steady pace in stabilized mode were about 4 minutes with the 450 mAh battery and 6.5 minutes with the 750 mAh battery. When flying each of these batteries back to back, I expected the larger battery to make the quad feel heavier in the air and less responsive to throttle, but in fact the opposite was true. The larger 750 mAh battery made the quad feel more powerful and I had to be a little bit more sensitive on the throttle, but I got used to it quickly. Since this is a Deadcat style frame, the props are mostly out of the camera's view. This microquad isn't really designed for freestyle or fast flying, but you can still have a bit of fun with it. Taking it outdoors, I really felt the difference between the two battery capacities. The smaller battery seemed too lightweight, even on a pretty much windless day. You can see those vibrations in the camera and the prop wash was really noticeable. When I switched to the 750 mAh batteries, I did notice that it was more stable, had less prop wash, but there was still a bit of camera shake. Overall though, it was more stable and a lot better. There are prop guards that come in the box that you can install if you want to, but there are a few things that you should be aware of. The motors have to be taken off the frame in order to install the prop guards. Flywoo does include longer screws for reattaching the motors with the prop guards on. I did have to remove the zip tie that was securing the ELRS antenna so that the prop guards would fit. However, Flywoo did let us know that they will be positioning the antenna in a different way in the future to avoid signal obstruction and to get better range. So it also looks as if it'll be in a position that won't interfere with attaching the prop guards. After installing the prop guards, I took it for a flight with the larger 750 mAh battery, and indoors it flew perfectly fine. The flight time was reduced, the hovering throttle position was definitely higher, and the quad felt a little bit heavier in the air, but the upside was that I could bump into things and just keep flying. I even missed gaps pretty badly and didn't have to crash or disarm. When I switched to the smaller 450 mAh battery, it felt severely underpowered with the prop guards on. I really couldn't maintain good altitude and I just kept crashing. So I switched back to the larger battery and took it outdoors. On this day, there was a constant breeze during the flight, so the camera view was not smooth. Because of the extra weight of the prop guards, pulling out of dives definitely needed more throttle, but I adjusted and compensated fairly quickly. Flywoo did actually release a CLI command that can be pasted into Betaflight, which improves the flight performance of these quads. I'll leave a link below if you want to check that out. After doing the update, flying with the smaller battery indoors with the prop guards installed, the quad felt much better. It was still heavy, but flyable. When I flew with the larger battery, it actually felt amazing indoors, but heading outside, the camera was still a bit shaky in the wind. I think the prop guards really only work best in a completely windless environment. Otherwise, you'll just get quite a bit of camera shake. Maybe in the future, Flywoo can release an update that will have a PID profile you can choose if you want to fly with prop guards on. But for now, if you want to fly with prop guards, you're gonna have a bit of camera shake if there's any wind. I do remember that even with the prop guards off, the camera was slightly shaky outdoors. So after doing the update, I flew outside again without prop guards with the larger battery, and it seems to be a little bit smoother. There is some camera shake, but overall the flying experience is improved. As you can see, this update actually seemed to make a difference and make the flight feel a lot smoother. It's a noticeable improvement, but if you have the knowledge to do some more fine-tuning, I'm sure you can get it to fly even smoother. All right, moving on to the FR16. As mentioned earlier, we have the analog version, and because it's an X-frame, the props are very much in view. My flight times indoors were about 4 minutes and 6 minutes with each battery. For me as an average flyer, the FR16 feels quite similar to the DC16 when just flying indoors. It's pretty easy to do flips and rolls indoors, so if you have a larger indoor space, this would be a great quad to practice freestyle. And you can also install prop guards on this if you want to. But since this was made to be a fast flying freestyle quad, I didn't end up installing the prop guards, but I'd say if you want to use them, just make sure you are flying with a larger 750 milliamp hour battery and you should be good to go. Outdoors, I initially was not impressed with how this flew. The prop wash was exceptionally bad, especially with the smaller battery. Flying with the larger battery was a lot better and overall not bad. But two things changed to make this fly actually quite nicely. I did the update that Flywoo released and I switched out the 4-bladed props with the 3-bladed props. Doing both of those things made this quad fly like a dream. You can do tricks, you can do dives, and I feel more in control of every move that I want to make. So definitely make sure you have the latest version of Flywoo's update. Now let's compare the specs of each quad. The motors are the same size, but the DC16 has a lower KV than the FR16. The HD0 DC16 has a flight controller that includes the Express ELRS receiver, but the antenna is mounted here externally. Whereas the analog FR16 has a separate ELRS receiver with a ceramic antenna right here. The HD0 version uses the Whoop Light bundle, and as you can see, going from outdoors to indoors and back out, the exposure compensation is quite good. Same with Flywoo's analog Nano Camera V3. It handles exposure changes quite nicely. I did notice that these frames kind of protrude a little bit to help protect the motors against crashes. I guess depending on how you crash, it will offer some protection, but of course your motors will not be completely protected. Originally, the FR16 came with 4-bladed props, but Flywoo has said that they will include these 3-bladed 1608 props in the future. They just fit on the 1.5 millimeter motor shaft by friction, so it's a good idea before you take off to make sure that all your props are fully secured. The 3D printed canopies on these quads don't seem to allow any camera angle adjustments. I did try to make some adjustments, but I'd say that the camera angle is pretty much fixed on both of these quads. Notice that the power cable uses an A30 plug, which means that the batteries will also need to have A30 plugs. But they can apparently supply more current and less resistance, which means longer flight times and better performance. The 3D printed battery compartments on these quads can be twisted off if you need to remove it. Getting it back on might require a toothpick or something similar just to get it situated. The TPU is flexible and is supposed to accommodate different sizes and shapes of batteries, but I did notice that the 450 milliamp hour batteries fit nicely in the TPU. But after using the larger 750 batteries, the battery compartment did stretch a little bit, which made it so that the 450s were not really loose, but just not quite as snug. So if you do crash, the battery might just eject a little bit more easily with the smaller 450s. But as I said earlier, it doesn't really make sense to have the smaller batteries because larger ones only give you better performance, more flight time. It's a no-brainer. Here are the various weights of these two quads in different configurations. To charge these new A30 batteries, Flywoo sells this 1S high voltage LiPo battery charger. You can charge A30 batteries up here or PH2 along the sides, but there can only be 6 batteries plugged in at once and only 1 per port. So if you have an A30 battery plugged in here, you cannot also plug in a PH2 battery on that same port. It has a 5-volt, 3-amp USB-C port on the side, which will power the charger. Red light means the battery is not fully charged. Green light means the battery is fully charged. However, green light also means there's nothing plugged in. And the reason that's a problem for me is that this particular battery doesn't seem to want to work. If I plug it into a quad, it does not power up the quad. And when I plug it into the charger light just stays green. So maybe in a future release, there should be a different color for just a standby LED light. Here's everything that comes in the box. Prop guards are included, as well as various screws. The screwdriver will work for the motor screws and the camera screws, but you will need a hex tool, which is not provided, if you need to tighten the stack screws. Batteries are not included, so you'll have to buy them separately. Because I'm not too familiar with HD0 or Express LRS, during the setup process, I did run into a few issues. So I'll give you a brief overview of what I did to get everything going. Of course, this will only apply to these two exact model configurations. First, I updated the Express LRS receiver on both quads. I plugged in a full battery and waited about 60 seconds or until I saw the ELRS Wi-Fi network on my computer or phone. I connected to it, and you might need to enter a password, which will be Express LRS. And then in the browser, I typed 10.0.0.1. This page showed me the current version of the Express LRS firmware. With that info, I disconnected the quad, went back online, and opened up the Express LRS configurator on my computer. I chose the latest release, DIY 2.4. Then I made sure the device matched what I saw that was already installed. I chose Wi-Fi as my flashing method. I set 30 seconds as the auto Wi-Fi on interval, and then I entered my binding phrase. Finally, I clicked on build. Once that finished, I powered up the quad, waited for the Wi-Fi to connect, and then I updated the firmware with the file that I had just created. I did all this while keeping the quad cool with a fan. Next, since the DC16 uses the HD0 video system, I updated the HD0 VTX by downloading the firmware, unzipping the Whoop Lite VTX file, and copying it to the SD card of my goggles. Then I connected my goggles to the actual VTX board using the cables and adapters I received with my goggles. In the goggles menu, I flashed the firmware to the latest version. And finally, I turned on the radio, powered up the quad, and instantly they were bound because I used the same binding phrase. Then I plugged the quads into my computer one at a time using the micro USB port, opened up Betaflight, and I checked that the channel map was correct and my control sticks were working. Then I got my switches set up. And one thing I did notice was that after I set up the beeper on a switch, I flipped the switch and I didn't hear anything. So maybe these quads don't have beepers. I did make some small tweaks to the on-screen elements and changed each quad's name. The main problem I was having was on the HD0 DC16. I didn't have any on-screen elements. Normally, there should be an option here in Betaflight that says VTX MSP plus DisplayPort, but that was not listed. The solution from Flywoo was to paste in that CLI command into Betaflight, and that did fix it. Another solution would have been to use this HD0 VTX preset in Betaflight, and then choose the relevant options, and finally save. Also, I normally like to see the VTX power level when I'm flying. When I added it to the OSD, I'd mistakenly chosen the TX uplink power. Here is the option that I should have chosen. Now I can see the power levels in the on-screen display. To wrap this up, if you want a fast and agile quad to practice freestyle, then choose the FR16. If you just want to cruise around, do proximity flying through gaps, outside or inside, then the DC16 should be your choice. No matter which one you decide on, buy extra 3-bladed props, 750 mAh high voltage version 2 A30 LiPo batteries, and of course Flywoo's A30 battery charger. And that's about it. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments. Don't forget to check the description for any updated info or links to the CLI commands. Thanks for watching Ready, Set, Drone. See you next time.